We need the Bible, the word of the Lord, for our everyday living. Join host pastor of the Pegwell Community Church, Reverend Lester R. Murrow, as he brings to you
the simplicity of the gospel.
Good day, Pastor Murrow of Pegwell Community Church in Christchurch in Barbados. Happy to be with you again today to encourage you as you walk along with the Lord. Last time we were together, we were talking about walking in the Spirit. We were talking about walking in love. We were talking about the fact that we were on a journey and we got to fulfill this journey. Today, I want to encourage you to serve the Lord with gladness as you travel along the road. As you travel on this journey, we want to serve the Lord with gladness. You know, as you look around the world today, the entire world, because of the pandemic, it seems as though people are bitter, and people are dismal, people are heartbroken and melancholy, people are mournful, they're pessimistic, they're somber, people are sorrowful and they're somehow bereaved, people are cheerless, forlorn, gloomy, grief-stricken, heavy-hearted. People are low-spirited. People are morbid. People are out of sorts. People are sick at the heart. People are weeping. And if we as children of God are not careful, we will find ourselves in the same state because there is so much on the radio, so much negativity everywhere. Well, people say they are facts, but they may be facts, but they're still negative facts. And people are prone to become glum and distressed and down in the dumps. That's what's characterizing the world today. What I want to tell you, however, is that the Lord wants us as people of God to be cheerful. God wants us to be contented and joyful. God even wants us to be overjoyed. God wants us to be rejoicing, to be sparkling, to be effervescent, to be bright and to be cheery. God wants us to be hilarious. God wants us to be lighthearted and joyous and beaming. God wants us to be radiant. As a matter of fact, God will love us to be as pleased as punch. God will love us to be tickled pink rather than being on the other side. Listen to what the scripture says. The Bible says in Psalm 100, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. We tend to be grumpy and remorseful and critical and resentful. But the Lord said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. So joyful, number one. The next thing he said is serve the Lord with gladness. God wants us to be a glad people. Serve the Lord with gladness. It says, come into his presence with singing, not with grumbling and groaning and being grouchy, but come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he's still God. He's still God. He's still the Almighty. He's still the creator and possessor of all things. He's the Most High God. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us and not we ourselves. We are still his people and the sheep of his pasture. So listen to this. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Not being grumpy. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Enter into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto them. What wonderful words. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. The Lord deserves more than we're giving him today. The Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his truth endureth to all generations. We serve a good God. So brethren, as we walk with the Lord, some may even be strolling, some may be just taking a stride, some may be just marching, others may be hiking, some may be jaunting. But as we travel with the Lord on our way to the celestial city, God wants us to be more joyful than we are. Listen to what the Word of God says concerning happiness and laughter and jollity. Listen to what the Word of God says. Philippians chapter 4 and verse 4 says, rejoice in the Lord always, at all times. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I'm repeating it. He says rejoice. He didn't say frown and be miserable. Rejoice in the Lord. Proverbs 17 and verse 22 says, a merry heart doeth well like a medicine. A merry heart doeth well like a medicine. And then Psalms 32 and verse 11 says, be glad in the Lord and rejoice. Brethren, if you are downspirited, if you are cast down all the time, this is going to be very, very bad. Because some people are like that, they are suicidal. Some actually commit suicide. All sorts of things happen. There's more problems in the home, family problems, there's abuse, all kinds of things, because people are not rejoicing in the Lord. The Bible says, and in Psalm 126 and verse 2, that when the Lord turned the captivity of Jacob, then our mouth was filled with laughter. Our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue was singing. Brethren, there's a time to weep and there's a time to laugh. There's a time to mourn and there's a time to dance. Look, this is our time, I believe, in the Lord. This is our time to laugh. This is our time to laugh. So, brethren, let me give you some tips on how you can be joyful. Everybody around you, 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand. It should not come near you. Everybody in the office could be dumb and dispirited and disheartened and disgusted and all that. But this is what you can do. Listen, you can spend some more time with the Lord more regularly. Spend some more time with the Lord. In the presence of the Lord, there's a fullness of joy. Remember who's Lord over your life. He's not broke, busted, and disgusted. Jehovah is our God. Is anything too hard for him? No. So number two, you can remember who's the Lord our God. Number three, get in the habit of reading your Bible every day. Sometimes you take medicine from the doctor three times a day. Why not read a portion of scripture three times a day if you can? Listen to worship music. Watch out for negative thoughts. Those negative thoughts are going to get you down. Watch out for negative thoughts. And there's some other things that you can do, and you have to do them for yourself. You know what? You got to trash those negative thoughts and the negative people who come with those negative thoughts. Some people are overwhelmed by their negative thoughts, and they have a real problem getting those negative thoughts. Trash those negative thoughts. And you also, when you wake up in the morning, you need to remind yourself of at least three things you can be grateful for. You're grateful to be alive. You're grateful for family. You're grateful that you're saved and you're on your way to glory. And mornings when you get up, remember three things that you can be grateful for. These things will cheer you up. Find something in your day that triggers a feeling of gratitude. What can you be grateful to God for? What can you be grateful? What can I be grateful to God for today? Take time to appreciate something that didn't happen during the day. You were not evicted. You didn't get sick. You didn't get an accident. Think of things, some things that did not happen during that day. And I tell you something, your spirit will be lifted. You'll be able to serve the Lord with gladness amidst all the doom and the gloom that is around. Listen, commit doing one nice thing for yourself every day. Commit doing one nice thing for yourself. Listen to yourself. See where you're negative. See where you're pessimistic. See where you're degrading yourself and work on that. Learn also to forgive yourself. What has happened to the truth is not necessarily your fault. What has happened because you don't have a lot of money is not necessarily your fault. So learn to forgive yourself and accept yourself as you are right now, but make a great effort to improve. Accept yourself as you are. Don't tear yourself down. Don't pull yourself down. And next thing you could do is eliminate toxic people out of your life. Eliminate toxic people out of your life and in your workplace. Prioritize your health. Stop skipping meals. And you'll be able to serve the Lord with gladness as the Lord requires of us. The Lord said, enter into his gates with thanksgiving. These gates doesn't necessarily have to mean the house of God where we're excluded from right now. But you have your gates. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Remember that the Lord is your shepherd. Remember that the Lord will not withhold anything good from you if you walk uprightly. Remember that the Lord loves you. Remember that the Lord has plans for your life. I know the plans I have for you, saith the Lord. So our text today again tells us that we must serve the Lord with gladness. Brethren, we are not on the Via Dolorosa where we are so sad because, you know, the people on the Via Dolorosa, the day that Christ was crucified, they must have been so sad when they saw how he was beaten and bruised and the cross on his shoulders and all that. I believe everybody was glum. We don't have to be like that, brethren. We are not on the Via Dolorosa. Maybe for us, this could be our Easter. When Jesus rose from the dead, May Jesus raise up in you today. And may Jesus cause you to be rid of all that negative stuff, or as much as you possibly can. And as you focus your eyes on Jesus, as you look unto God, the author and the finisher of our faith, I can guarantee you that you will not be always, you will not be so down. You will not be so sad. You will not be so troubled. You will not be so downcast. No, because God is on your side. I pray that today you will take this little advice and that you will serve the Lord with gladness. If the Lord doesn't come, if you're still alive, you're going to be on that road for a long time. So learn how to serve God with gladness. May God bless you today with a merry heart. May God bless you today with the ability to smile and to laugh and to joke in the name of Jesus. And I give him all the praise and I give him all the thanks. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
If you do not have a local assembly, feel free to join us for an exhilarating time of worship. Our services are Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Sunday evening, healing and deliverance at 6:30 p.m. Join us in prayer on Tuesdays at 7 p.m. and for Bible study on Thursdays at 7 p.m. Let's fellowship and enjoy
the simplicity of the gospel.